I'm Hadas and welcome to Tip Talk. How many times have you eyeballed things? Well, no more. You can easily use rulers and guidelines. Let me show you how. In this episode, I'd like to show you how you can use rulers and guidelines in your design. This will help you make your design much more accurate and, of course, the design process much easier. Now, before we hop into rulers and guidelines, I want to show you that you can also align your objects through the position tab at the top white bar. Once I click on that, I can pick either to center it in the middle, top, left, right, bottom. You choose what's right for you. Now let's go to the rulers and guidelines. For that, I will go to the top blue bar and click on File, or if you have the View feature, you click on View. Under View or under File, you will find the Show Rulers and Show Guides. You will have to click on them to activate them. Now, once I clicked on that, you can see that the rulers are added at the top and on the left side of my design. To add the guidelines, all I have to do is click on my mouse and drag the guidelines to its position. I can add as many guidelines as I need. Now, as you can see, at certain points, the guidelines will turn into purple. This will happen once they snap to an object, which makes it very easy to find the exact spot. They will also turn purple once you reach the margins that indicate the center frame inside your design. Now, two things you need to know. Once you add your guidelines, this will be the same guidelines on each and every page that you add. Of course, you can add more or delete them, but you have to know that this will affect the other pages that you have. Another thing I want to show you is if you want to delete these guidelines, you can either just drag them outside and off they go, or you can right-click on your mouse and then you have the option to either add a horizontal or a vertical guide, or clear all guides in one click. If you want to delete the rulers from your design sheet, then you just have to go back to View or File and then click again Show Rulers, and they're gone. One more important thing that you need to know is about the measurement unit. It will always be according to the measurement unit that you picked for your design. If you picked pixels, then these will be pixels. And if you chose a different measurement unit, then it will be according to that. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Do share with us your perfectly aligned designs in the comments below. We really love seeing them. And I'll see you next time. Bye.
Wow, thank you, Hadas, for these precious tips. And thank you for watching this video until the end. I have two playlists right here for those of you who want to go a bit deeper and keep learning. This one right here is a collection of step-by-step Canva tutorials. And this one gathers all of our Canva Space webinar recordings where Canva experts teach about all sorts of topics.